Welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Ayush Jain and today I am giving you a demo of 16 line to 1 line multiplexer. The order code of this equipment is 38655. Now this is our equipment. In this is our power main on off switch. This is the 4 control inputs LS0 to LS1, LS3, LS1, LS2, LS3. This is the enable switch. This is the LED that shows you the enable switch on or off with logic 1 or 0. These are the LEDs from LD0 to LD15. These 16 LEDs shows the input signals 1 or 0 with logic 1 or 0. This is the output LY and LY bar. This is the one output LY bar and it is then complemented to LY with a NOT gate. Now, let me take you to the experiment. Our first experiment is to verify the operation of 16 line to 1 line digital multiplexer. For this, first of all, connect it to the AC mains 230 volt over here with the lead. Now switch on the power supply. The jewel light will glow. Now first check the enable switch. Turn it to logic 1. As you turn it to logic 1, you will notice that the LY bar output LED will glow irrespective of the control signal input. Whatever input I give, my output will be, my LY bar LED will glow because the enable switch is at 1 and it is complemented, so it works as off. Now put this enable switch to zero logic. Now give these 4 input signals, control signals, to different values from 0000 to 1111. This is 1111. Give all the 16 values according to the manual from 0000 right from up to this 1111. Give all these values and these LEDs. When we give value, suppose I am giving 0001. Now select any LED line as input signal and you have two positions, either 1 or 0. Set all the positions of these LEDs at different input signals. First, as I am giving 0001, now record all the output values of LY and LY bar according to the input signals of LED. When my control signal is 0001, I have two states for D0 or D1. As my input is 1, I take my D1 LED. First it is in 0 logic, my output is LY and LY bar is 01. When I turn it to 1 logic, my output is 10 of LY and LY bar. Similarly, make it to 2. This is my 2 in binary 0010. I'll take my D2 LED. First it is in logic 0 state, my output of LY and LY bar is 01. As I turn it to 1 state, my output is 10 of LY and LY bar. Similarly, take all the readings from D0 to D16 for the values of LS0 to LS3. Put different values, select the different LEDs and record all the readings according to the table given in the manual. You will have 32 readings, as there are 16 points and 2 values for each point. So there are 32 readings for the experiment 1. Record all the readings. That's it in the experiment 1. Now we move on to experiment 2. In this we demonstrate how multiplexer can be used to convert a parallel data input to a serial data output device. For this, switch off the supply first. Now switch on the supply. Put the enable switch to 0 logic. This condition will enable the IC1. This condition will enable the IC1. Now set all the LEDs. Now set all the LEDs to on position. To get the serial out from LSB, that is D0, to D15, set control logic initially to D0, initially to 0, S0 to S3, all are 0. Now, one step by one, take it from 0 to 15 and record the output values of LY and LY bar. As you can see in the table, set the values of S0 to S3 from 0000 to 1111 with a step of 1 and record the output value of LY and LY bar. When it is, initially it is 0000, now it is 0001, now it is 0010, now it is 0011, and record the values of LY and LY bar at every position. Now it is 1111, now record the output of LY and LY bar. Similarly, take all the readings and record the output of LY and LY bar as shown in our table present in our manual. These are the two experiments that we have to perform in this equipment. The inference of this second experiment is that parallel data available at input is converted to serial data and is available at output LY. This is the working of the second experiment. That's it in this equipment. For any further information, please consult the lab manual. Thank you.